We start our tour of King's Lynn by entering the town through the grand south gates. The south gates, originally constructed as a defensive structure, formed an integral part of the town's fortifications, which consisted of both a wall and protection from the sea, starting in the 13th century. This gatehouse underwent extensive reconstruction during the 15th century and was later restored in the 1980s. After parking the car, we walked along South Quay. It is a peaceful place to relax and watch the odd boat float by, from wharfs converted into restaurants. At the heart of the original medieval town stands the splendid St. Margaret's Church. Construction of the church commenced in 1101, but only fragments of the original structure have survived. The present-day building, which we see today, dates from the 13th century. The church has many captivating architectural elements and notable characteristics. The highlight of the heritage quarter is undoubtedly the magnificent town hall, which originates from the 15th century. This remarkable structure has a distinctive checkered flint front, complemented by grand, impressive windows and the arms of both Queen Elizabeth I and King Charles II. The main shopping street in King's Lynn is on the High Street. The street contains a mix of the usual high street names and small local traders. This statue of King John is the work of artist Alan Harriet, who based the image on sketches and theatrical portrayals of the king. As we proceed along, we come to Purfleet Quay. During medieval times, this was a navigable waterway, taking boats into the heart of the town. It also marked the boundary between the two separate medieval settlements, forming Lynn. Nowadays, Purfleet Quay has transformed into a serene inlet, offering a tranquil and peaceful ambience. Located on Purfleet Quay is the Custom House. This magnificent building was constructed in 1684 and originally served as a hub for merchants' exchange. From 1718 right up to 1989, the building was used by customs and excise, hence the name. It has now been refurbished and houses captivating displays and the Tourist Information Centre. A famous name linked with King's Lynn is George Vancouver. In 1792, George Vancouver was a captain in the British Royal Navy and sent to survey the North American coast from San Francisco right up to Alaska. Vancouver was the first European to enter the main harbor area of the present-day city of Vancouver. The map drawn by Vancouver was so precise that it was still used for navigation into the 20th century. This is the King's Lynn Library, constructed in the early 20th century by the philanthropist Andrew Carnegie. It is still the town's main library and continues to captivate visitors with its intriguing history. That was our day in King's Lynn. Did you like it? If so, feel free to subscribe to this channel, as we'd love to share more videos like this. Thank you.